Okay, hey guys, this is the last and the final video in this series about financial independence. I have been discussing about this since past 2 weeks. If you have not watched those videos, then make sure that you watch even them along with this video, because all of these three videos and to be following them in its entirety, it's very important to bring about financial independence, right? So in this video, I'm going to discuss with you about a very important how to manage your money management system that was taught to me by my mentor, Mr. Siddharth Rajshekhar, and he was taught this by his mentor, who is Vic Streisius. He has a very detailed method on this. He has a very detailed program that's actually free. It's the Wealth Management Blueprint, or Wealth, yeah, something like that. So if you would like to watch this in very, very much detail, then you make sure that you go and watch it. I will be placing the links in the description box below so that you can just go ahead and get that also. So make sure that you watch this video till the end to get the entire scoop. Okay, stay tuned. Make sure that you subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon. When you click on the bell icon, select all notifications so that you get notified about all the videos that I upload. Okay, so let's begin about the money management thing. There are going to be 5 different steps that I will be discussing that are very important that you split up your money, the money that you are earning. Now, whether you are doing business, whether you are doing job, whether you are into freelancing, whatever money you are earning, you have to make sure that you split up all of that money into 5 different things, into 5 different accounts in such a way that each of the account will stand for some different thing that we will be looking into it in just a little bit. But yes, you have to split that money into 5 different parts, and then let's get into it. The first part is the T. Now, this is called the TWCGO system, and the T stands for taxes. This is going to be 30% of your income, whatever income you are earning. Spare 30% and all of the taxes that you pay during a month, just spare that 30%, and you have to pay off those taxes from this 30% account. Okay, so this includes the GST, the income tax, etc. And then comes the 10%. Okay, the second chunk of the salary that you are going to spare is going to be the 10% of your income, which is going to go to the wealth section of your account. And yeah, you have to have 5 different bank accounts for this thing to work, because yeah, then you need to actually put your money into 5 different accounts so that you can manage them in this way. So the second account is going to be the 10% wealth account, and in this account, you will actually, from this account, whatever money you get, you will be investing that in real estate, stocks, gold, silver, and it is used to multiply your wealth. Okay, invest in things that will increase their value in money with time. So when I talk about this investment, it has to be in a way that if you invest into something, its value, the thing that you are buying, its value is going to increase over time. Now, you know, a lot of people usually they spend in mobile phones, gadgets. Gadgets are something who have a deteriorating market value. So don't, that is not an investment, okay? That is not a healthy, that's not a good investment of money, right? It's not called an investment. It's called you are putting money into some thing, into a utility, right? And that utility is going to get worn out. It's going to get used out with time. So it does not get included into, it doesn't get counted in the 10% of the wealth section, right? You don't have to buy all of that stuff from your wealth section. The third part is the charity. 10% goes to charity, and this is going to be the 10% of the total income that you are earning per month. Now, you know, don't tell me that I earn this much, why do I do charity? When I start earning a lot, I will start putting into charity. See, it does not mean that how much you earn. It just means that you just are sparing a little amount and giving it to charity no matter what. See, to give, we are doing work so that we can give to this world, right? We are already giving our services, plus just spare a little amount of money every month so that you are giving it away unconditionally to somebody who is in need of that money, right? The third part is going to be the G. G is the general. General is the 30% of your income, and this is going to go for the rent, the mortgage, bills and loans and groceries, household expenses, plus the outings that you go. All the expenses are going to come from this account, that is the general account, right? And then there is going to be O, the operations account, and this is the account where you will be taking money for business tools, ad budgets, etc. And yeah, now a lot of people who are working, who are like, who just have a job, they don't have any business expenses. In that case, you can actually save this 20% along with your wealth. Okay, yeah, so this operations is 20%, right? So yeah, you can actually shift this 20% into your wealth account. So it will be like 30%. 30% for general, and then the next two sections will work out for you, right? So I will be actually putting all of this into a PDF so that it gets better for you to understand, right? So I'll be just linking that PDF down in the description box below just to make things easier for you. And I would love to know from you, how did you like this money management system? And see, yeah, it's not my own, okay? It's not something that I created. It's something that I learned from somebody, and I just feel that this is excellent way of managing money. Plus also, I just said that try to make 5 different bank accounts and have 5 different cards, you know, have a card each for all of those account and all of those accounts. And so whenever you are going to have some general expenditure, you know, you're going to spend something from on your family, you just have to have that credit card with you, right? And then you have a separate card that is you just have put aside for charity. And as soon as you see somebody that who needs your help, who needs the money that you have, you can just, you know, go ahead and give them that charity amount, right? And you will exactly know how much money you can actually give for charity, how much money you exactly have to spend on your family. This way you will not be spending in the wrong way, right? A lot of people, they just complain that by the end of the month, no matter how much they are earning, by the end of the month they just don't have any money. So when you are going to manage your money in this way, you will stop complaining about that, right? So yeah, so this is the video for you, and this completes the financial independence series. And if you are interested in going for the more in-depth, you know, training for this, I will be placing the link to Vic Streisius's course and the wealth management blueprint, something like that he has, but it's like a fuller and a more detailed study in this method. So yeah, so just go ahead and look into that also. I will see you again in my next video. If you have liked this video, hit the like button. If you feel that this video can help somebody, do share this video with that person. I will see you again in my next video. Until then, keep following the path of your soul's purpose, because you are born for a reason. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.